Hello and welcome to this edition of Stay Fit with CNBC TV18. My name is Shibani Gharat. Now, Surya Namaskar or Sun Salutation is one of the most popular yoga routines. In fact, I learnt it from my grandmother that performing Surya Namaskar early in the morning has several health benefits. So today, we're going to learn the steps of Surya Namaskars. In fact, it is performed in steps. And to tell us all those steps, we have yoga expert Shammi Gupta with us. Shammi, so good to have you on the show today.
Thank you, Shivani.
What are the benefits of performing Surya Namaskar?
So, Shivani, Surya Namaskar is a combination of 12 postures. And this series has been designed so beautifully that with Surya Namaskar series alone, you can stretch, flex, pull, push, and do so many things. So if you look at Surya Namaskar, it has maximum presence of primitive movements. So you can actually manipulate your body in so many ways and you can get maximum benefit.
All right, so let's just begin all the 12 steps of Surya Namaskar.
So the first posture, it is Namaskarasana. So you stand tall, your feet grounded to the floor, you pull your thighs into the groin, open up your chest, eyes fixed. We are moving to position number 2. So stretch your arms in front, inhale, stretch your arms up, maintain that involvement of your body which we had created in posture number 1. You're trying to touch the ceiling. You feel the vacuum in your core, so automatically you're engaging your core into bandhas, which is the Udyan Bandh. Now squeeze your hips and let the whole body go back. Normal breathing. We are moving to position number 3. Move your hips out so that you can lengthen the midsection. Keep pushing your hips at the back. And now you're trying to get the upper part of your body parallel to the floor. In the process, you can feel your hamstrings getting stretched. Hold. Position number 3 is Uttanasana. Palms by the side of your feet. If you cannot touch the floor, that's absolutely fine. Push your stomach to the thigh, then your chest, and at the end your forehead. Position number 4. Right leg at the back. Ashva Sanchalanasana, equestrian pose. So your knee above your ankle, thigh parallel to the floor, your right leg has gone back, fingertips on the floor, you separate your chest from the thigh. Push your thigh up and push your hips down. We are moving to position number 5, which is Adho Mukha Svanasana, popularly known as dog pose. Palms on the floor, stretch your fingers, left leg at the back. Legs are 6 inches apart or hip width apart. Your toes are parallel to each other. Heels are slightly out. The outer edge of the heel is in line with the little toe. Push your palms, arms tall. Your head in between your arms. Push your chest in. We are moving to position number 5. So come on the toes. Heels up. This will involve your core. Maintain that involvement, move forward. In the process, get your knees on the floor. Chest up and then roll your elbows in, push your elbows in and close to your body, chest and chin on the floor. As you inhale, slide your legs out, go up as per your comfort. So you press the frontal part of your feet on the floor, push your thighs on the floor, go up as much as you can. Roll your shoulders at the back, open up your chest, tall, up and back. Exhale. The first 7 postures are independent postures. Now we are repeating the postures in reverse order. Toes on the floor, knees off the floor. Position number 8, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Stretch. In position number 4, your right leg had gone back. In 9, right will come forward in between your arms. Knee above your ankle, thigh parallel to the floor. Adjust your hips in one line, chest away from the thigh. 10, legs in front, Uttanasana. Exhale, go down. Relax with deep breathing for a few seconds. Position number 11, palms together, stretch out, feel your core. Halfway, you're moving up with your core. Up, tall, stretch out, maintain the length of your body. Maintaining the length of your body will maintain the firmness of your body. Tall. And now squeeze your hips, engage your core. There is extension of the frontal part of your body. Go back. position number 12. And relax.
You know, we have done all steps of Surya Namaskar, so we'll have to repeat this on the other side too as well. Shammi, I wanted to ask you, how many times do we have to repeat this?
So what they should do initially, they should, if they have 20 minutes, they should see how many they can do comfortably in 20 minutes. Now, you know, when you continue to do the same thing for some time, body gets used to that. So then they'll have to start manipulating it.
Okay, Shammi, thank you so much. Thanks for showing us how to do a Surya Namaskar in like the right way. That's it for now. Till I see you next time, sweat, smile, repeat.